That is how one shall understand that aspirations and vibrations of the directions and cycles of the time should match together. If they don't match, then Kala Chakra remains with the same speed, but the vibrations of the Vastu and directions go on lagging in matching with this speed of the time. Then it happens like the Vakri Grahas, and then whole eventology gets spoiled. That's why Tithi, Muhurta, Astro is most important in understanding the basics of the Vastu. That's what we call as dynamics of the Vastu. While learning the commentary on Rajavallabh, we have learned that any treatment to be done to the south and southwest, one should observe Nanda Tithi. Any treatment corrections to be done in the west, northwest, one should observe Bhadra Tithi. And any corrections to be done in the north and northeast, one should adjust all that with the Jaya Tithi. And for all movements related to northeast and east even, or southeast, should be observed on the Purna Tithi. We avoid the Rikta. That is how we are trying to match the vibrations of the Vastu with the cycles of the time. Whenever any land is having slope to the east, in such cases, one should erect one stambha of Vishnukanta type, that is octagonal one, in the southeast, and simultaneously permanently should burn magic mixture below that, near that stambha. And when you establish the Vishnukanta stambha, then that establishment should be done on Purna Tithi and use copper lingams to fill all that stambha and do the copper paneling to that stambha. And on the same stambha, if you make one dvaja of the earth element, that is with the yellow flags, then that particular will act as the foolproof treatment for southeast loam. Then whatever good advantage I get from the east continues to give the same experience for southeast low also, because it is treated.